these high school boys and girls are having a hop at the local soda fountain. Innocently, they dance. Innocent of a new and deadly menace lurking behind closed doors. Marijuana, the burning weed with its roots in hell.
Ah, man. That's some heavy shit, man.
Got blunt?
Got weed?
As the legalization of medical marijuana and marijuana for recreational use begins to spread across the states, the use of marijuana is becoming more acceptable throughout our culture. With this, a new trend emerges. Hash oil, the new growing trend among the pot-smoking communities. This product gives even the biggest potheads a head rush and a high like the first time they got stoned. This is not a very well-known method of ingesting marijuana, but this trend is spreading fast and across country. So I decided to take a deeper look on the culture and the use of wax concentrates.
I've been extracting hash for about 4 years now. I started out making hash, doing cold water extraction with ice cubes and water and making bubble hash, which is different than what we made today. I've been making earwax hash or variations of oil for, I'd say, about 3 years, and the difference is instead of using cold water, you use cold gas. So we're using butane. In this case today, you could also use hexane or CO2, but butane is the most efficient for the average layman to be doing on a daily basis. It comes out quite cold, so it binds to the THC molecules and then pushes it through the tube and extracts into a lower facility. Once you extract it to the lower facility, usually a Pyrex pan or something, you would apply some sort of heat to it in order to quickly purge the gas out, like the leftover butane or CO2. CO2 is completely harmless if you use CO2 to extract it. Butane is obviously a gaseous cancer-causing agent, and we all know about this. We all involved in the dab community at least should know about this because it definitely has its downsides, but doing whatever process you do to the fullest extent, not cutting corners, can minimize all of your chances of any negative effects. I think there will be a change in the culture. I think it's going to be broadened at this point to beyond our locale. I think it'll be exposed to the entire nation at that point, and people will realize that this is a legitimate business.
From the manufacturers, the product either goes to a dispensary, depending on if the manufacturer is licensed. Otherwise, it is distributed illegally, and in some cases, shipped across the country.
I supply the wax demand across country. Back where I grew up, you paid 20 bucks for a 0.8 a bud. Now that the wax has hit the shelves, the game has totally changed. The demand increases every day back east, yet no one is able to supply the quality and the quantity that is expected. That's where I fit in. Out here, it's the opposite. Every kid on the corner can blow fire wax. Out here, you pay 700 bucks an ounce, which breaks down to be 25 bucks a gram. You can send it back for about 900 bucks an ounce, which breaks down to 40 bucks a gram. Sell it at home for about 60 bucks a gram, which equals out to be 1700 bucks an ounce. Normally, I get several orders for several ounces. I am the middleman. I get paid to get a product from the manufacturer to the consumer. I've done close to 300 shipments in the past 3 years, with only 4 that I've now made it. All you need in order to have your own empire is a vacuum sealer, a prepaid cell phone, the manufacturer, the street smarts, and most importantly, a loyal clientele. Your clients are your most important asset. They must have the understanding that the furthest you take it is to the post office. You cannot guarantee that it arrives the next day. I'm good at what I do because I was once in these kids' positions. I know the quality that is expected. If you don't send it what is expected, then they just won't come back to you. It's as simple as that. You must earn their loyalty. It's all about the long-term relationship in this business, because doing one shipment will not bring you a throne.
Wake up hour before class usually, go straight, living room, take a dab, go back to my room, take a shower, go to class, come back, take a dab before my next class. It's a continuous cycle. I pretty much take about like 10 tabs a day. I got into dabs my sophomore year, about like a little over 2 years ago, and I was offered it a few times and smoked it, and I was just like, ultimate high, just instantly. And just like, I just loved it on like, first high, caught me. I like dabs over weed because it's more of a clean high. It actually like gives me more energy opposed to weed. When I smoke weed, I feel groggy and tired. Don't want to do anything, you know, like couch potato status. But when I smoke hash, gets me up. Like I can go do stuff, go to class, do everything, function like a human being.
I've been smoking weed for 9.5 years now.
When I was in high school, I smoked weed. I probably started when I was in 9th grade. I started experimenting. I continued to smoke up until my sophomore year of college. And I just kind of weaned myself off it. I don't know, I grew out of it.
I definitely prefer smoking weed over taking dabs. For me, it's way more personal. It's like kind of a social thing too, where you're never just smoking a blunt like by yourself. You're always with friends. You're always, you know, it's like a thing you do. Like you guys meet up to smoke a blunt and talk and chill and all that.
If I could choose one word, intimidating. Very intimidating. No, I've taken dabs before. I see people taking dabs like I used to smoke weed, and I'm almost impressed because of my own reaction I had to it. I couldn't get off the couch. And the fact that they're able to take dabs and continue with their day, do homework even, it amazes me, but you know, everyone reacts to drugs differently.
My thing with dabs is more so that they're so new and it's so concentrated that like, I feel like it's really difficult to say exactly what's in it, if the process of making it is like safe and all these different things. And even the FDA hasn't like looked into it that much.
With the marijuana culture rapidly evolving, there's becoming more and more methods or new THC substances to get high off of. It is hard to say where wax concentrates stand. It has both its ups and its downs. From a user's perspective, they love it. From an outsider's perspective, this method of dabbing seems extreme. As growers inch closer to creating a perfect nug, the standards of marijuana are rising, and the THC concentrates have become extremely high. How much higher can these people get? How concentrated can they make these THC products? The question I have is, what's next?